Hello dear students, in this video we will be discussing about the concept and numerical on Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem. So basically Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem is used to determine the slope and deflection at any point. And Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem, there are two Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem. That is, first Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem is that if any structure, the material of which is linear elastic and the supports are unyielding and the temperature is constant, then the total strain energy with respect to the deflection component is equal to the force at that point. Okay, so this is our Kosciuszko-Leonnard's first theorem, that is the total strain energy, partial derivative of total strain energy with respect to the displacement component is equal to the load applied at that point in the direction of the deflection. So this is your P. So this is our Kosciuszko-Leonnard's first theorem. This is our Kosciuszko-Leonnard's first theorem. Okay, so and if I'm talking about the Kosciuszko-Leonnard's second theorem, so it states that if any structure, the material of which is linear elastic, supports are unyielding and the temperature is constant, then the first partial derivative of total strain energy with respect to the force gave us to the deflection at that point. So it is, mathematically it is represented as del u upon del p is equal to what? Delta. So this is the Kosciuszko-Leonnard's second theorem. Okay, so based on this concept, we'll solve one numerical on the cantilever beam subjected to point load at the free end, and we are interested in finding out the deflection at that free point. So take this example or take this question. So we need to find the deflection at the end of the cantilever beam using Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem. Okay, so and this is a cantilever beam, and this is a A point, and this is a B point, and at the free end we are having one vertical load, that is P, and the span of this cantilever beam is L. Okay, so what we need to do, we take one section xx here, this is our xx section. Okay, and at a distance of x from B point, at the point where the deflection is to be find out. Okay, so here we write the equation of bending moment at this xx section, and the bending moment at this xx section will be P into x with negative sign, because it is Hawking. So minus P into x is the bending moment at this xx section. And if I differentiate this bending moment with respect to the load, then it is del mx upon del p is equal to minus x. Okay. So this is our partial differentiation. Now by using Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem, we need to find the deflection at this B point. Okay. So from the concept of Kosciuszko-Leonnard's theorem, we are having del u upon del p is equal to our deflection part. So we are putting the value of strain energy here. Okay, so strain energy stored in any member is giving as integration of mx square dx upon 2ei. So this is mx square dx upon 2ei. Okay, so this is a strain energy, or you can say the resilience of the member. So del upon del p is equal to what? U is the value, mx square dx upon 2ei. So here del p is equal to what? Your integration of, if I replace this mx and differentiate del mx upon del b into dx upon ea. Okay, so mx square differentiation is 2 mx del mx upon del b, and 2 is 2 and 2 gets cancelled out, so dx upon ea. So it is here, if putting the value of limit is 0 to L, and mx value from here we are having minus px value here, so this is my minus px, and the del mx upon del b value is minus x here, so it is minus x, and this is your dx upon ea. Okay, so here you can see the, after putting the values of all the values of 0 to L, now you can solve here, that is your minus and minus is plus, so plus px square, p gets constant as is to be without. Okay, so this is your p upon ea, and this is 0 to L, and this is x square dx upon ea. So what is the integration of x square is x cube by 3. So here if I'm talking, this is p upon ea, and integration is x cube upon 3, and putting the value of 0 to L. So after putting upper limit, it is your p L cube upon 3 ea, and 0 is 0. So the final result will be del v is equal to what? P L cube upon 3 ea. Okay, so this is the standard results when your cantilever beam is subjected to point load at the free end, and the deflection will be given as PLQ upon 3EA. Okay, so by this way you can solve many problems on the Kosting-Leonis theorem. Okay, so thank you so much.